SQL Server 2019 introduces big data clusters. It has Spark integrated. Shiv is here to tell us all about that today on Data Exposed. Hi, and welcome to another episode of Data Exposed. I'm your host, Jeroen, and today we have Shiv here with us to talk about Spark on big data clusters. So welcome to the show, Shiv.
Thank you.
So Spark, let's start at the basics, right? What is Spark?
Spark is a unified big data processing engine that can work across your analytic workloads.
Okay, that doesn't sound very simple.
So let's break it down.
Okay.
So first let's talk about big data processing, right? Mm-hmm. Distributed big data. So last few years, what we've been seeing is a trend of enterprises collecting lots and lots of data.
Sure.
Right, from going from GBs of data, today we see an enterprise dealing with terabytes and petabytes of data.
Mm-hmm.
Now there's a problem there, right? The problem is that when you have such large scale of data, how do you really store that data, first of all, right?
Okay. Mm-hmm.
So at the start, we started with a single machine and scaling it vertically and having, you know,
right,
terabytes of hard disk, but data grew.
Yep.
Right, that vertical scaling was not really the answer for storing distributed data.
Mm-hmm.
A feasible, a more better solution, more resilient solution was distributed data, where we don't keep scaling a single machine to take on more and more data. What we do is we distribute the data across n number of smaller machines,
right?
And that's how we store big data.
So basically, we divide and conquer, right? We divide the work.
Exactly.
Okay. Mm-hmm.
So now we have taken care of the problem of storing the data. But
yep,
that's not all, right? The main problem is not storage of data.
No,
the main problem is that I need to gain insights of this data.
Yeah, when you process it, that's where the value is, right?
Exactly.
Mm-hmm.
So processing of this distributed data requires different engines. Spark is a big data compute engine,
okay,
like which can work across distributed data and compute and do your workloads on that. And it's just not distributed big data compute engine. It's also something that abstracts about the details of distribution from you. As
okay,
a user of Spark,
mm-hmm,
you don't have to bother about all the details of distribution. Like that's the whole beauty around Spark.
Okay, so you just give it an assignment and it will figure out, you know,
exactly,
how to distribute the work and be done as quickly as possible, hopefully.
Right.
Okay.
And then
cool,
when you're dealing with such kind of data, you don't want to be like tied down to a particular language,
mm-hmm,
right? You're like, oh, this is a big data compute engine, and now you use the flashy language that I've invented to process that. So Spark does something very beautiful there. Spark gives you a choice of language. It gives you, you can, if you're a Python programmer, you could program in Python, Scala, Java, you know, R. R is very popular about our data scientists, right?
Sure.
And Spark gives you an option to use R for your workload. So that's
okay,
what is Spark as a distributed compute engine.
So basically, you said we store it differently, right? But that's something we did for big data because of the problems of scaling upwards all the time. We're scaling up and now we're scaling out as well, right?
Right.
Then Spark works on that distributed layer and gives you the flexibility of choosing the language of choice too.
Yes. Yes.
Wow.
And there was still a bit more jargon into my sentence. I told you something about a unified compute engine,
uh-huh,
right? So let's slice and dice that a bit.
Okay.
As we saw, enterprises started getting more and more data,
mm-hmm,
the traditional workloads also move from transactional workloads to workloads which are analytic in nature.
Okay.
What do I mean by analytic workload?
Mm-hmm.
Workload where, you know, I'm analyzing a lot of data to get insights out of it,
mm-hmm,
and then maybe doing machine learning or deep learning. And
yep,
so traditionally, the phase from the transactional workloads also moved to analytic workloads. Analytic workloads had a variety of workloads from deep learning, machine learning, analytics, and streaming workloads. Now each of these workloads, you don't want a separate compute engine,
right,
to really, you know, build your skills on.
Ideally, you would learn one.
Exactly. That's what Spark does. Spark is a unified compute engine,
mm-hmm,
that allows you to work across all these workloads with the same set of principles. That's what Spark is about. A distributed compute engine,
right,
that abstracts out the details of distribution from you. It doesn't bother about the distribution details.
Mm-hmm.
Second, a unified compute engine, and above all, which I find it as a very, very powerful developer feature, it offers you the choice of language, where you could use Python, Scala, Java,
right,
or R, whatever you choose from. So
wow,
that's what Spark is.
Cool, that's very impressive. So, but Spark, that's fine. So what are we doing with Spark on SQL Server? Do we have anything?
So Spark, as you say, is basically Apache Spark. It's an open source compute engine.
Right.
What we have done in Big Data Cluster is we have brought you together this with SQL as single unified offering with SQL, right? And an end-to-end solution where you do not just get the compute engine, you get a complete end-to-end experience on using the compute engine.
So that will mean that since Spark is then integrated in Big Data Cluster, I can query the data in the Big Data Cluster using all the benefits you just described
exactly.
from Spark.
Exactly. And using the client tooling that you are all familiar with.
Wow. Okay, that's impressive. Wow. Okay, so how do I learn more? I mean, this sounds very new to me. So where do I find something?
Please go to the Big Data Cluster documentation, SQL
okay.
Server Big Data Cluster documentation,
mm-hmm.
and you will find a lot of discussion, a lot of comments and articles about Spark. Yeah, you will find the Big Data Cluster Spark examples in the SQL Server samples repository. That's where you get started.
Okay.
Yeah.
Cool. So we'll make sure to include those links in the description, so you'll find them there. And thanks, Shiv, for coming to the show. Thanks for explaining this.
I finally learned
what Spark is. And thanks for watching. And please like and subscribe. And I hope to see you next time.